Carl, Brennan and Daniel from Games, Brrraaains and Head-Banging Life, gbhblofficial.com. Short reaction time as we're checking out a track by the band Blanket, who have done this track in collaboration with Loathe. It also features Kadeem France. It's In Awe. I have never heard of this band. I've heard of Loathe. Proof, if you want, that the rock and metal name generator has completely run out of titles for bands. Blanket? Really? And Kadeem, this is your choice.
Kadeem France is the vocalist of Loathe.
There we go then.
Yeah. I don't know much about them. It came up in my like release radar thing from Spotify because I knew who Loathe were. And I listened to it once and I was like, that's all right. But I haven't seen this video or listened to it much. So I thought I'd see what your guys' thoughts were on it.
Well, your own thoughts as well.
Yeah. Isn't it like the name of Michael Jackson's kid? Blanket.
No idea.
Whatever it is, yeah, it is, isn't it?
Isn't that, is this MJ's kid featuring Loathe?
Maybe. All right.
he's the kid that Michael Jackson hung over the balcony back in the 90s.
Yeah, I think so. I remember the Daily Star putting that picture on front cover, you know.
The Daily Star. All right, yeah, so it's all a bit of a unknown for most all of us. So let's do this in 3, 2, 1, go. Shoegaze vibes.
None of them look like Michael Jackson.
Right, two things I'm going to start with. They're called Blanket because they will put you to sleep. That is what that is about. Not in a negative way, in the sense that it's dreamy post-rock music. You kind of chill, relax, sort of drift away to it. That's what I mean. Secondly, I do think they're cheeky fuckers for putting Loathe in their title in the way they did. And that is purely to try and get people to click in it, thinking that it's a this isn't a collaboration. It features the singer in the background, and that's fine, but it's not Blanket and Loathe. What the fuck's that about? I realized that about halfway through. I was like, oh, okay, this is generally just so when people put it in Loathe, they might hopefully find your video.
And it's like, it's why I did, because they tagged Loathe on their little Spotify thing and it came up in my release radar because I follow Loathe.
Which would be fine because it does feature your singer, but putting it as Blanket, comma, Loathe suggests something very different. Not just this is fun. If it had been Blanket in our official video featuring Kadeem France of Loathe, fine. But it's the way it's that comma, it's like it's supposed to be Blanket and Loathe. And it's like, is it though? is it, guys?
No.
No, it's not. But here's the thing. Like, the song's pretty boring for me personally. I'm a big fan of post-rock. I'm a big fan of shoegazy melodies. I'm a big fan of that dreary, dreamy kind of vocals and a bit more energy in the stuff and all that. But overall, I thought this was quite boring. I thought it was quite bland. It kind of felt a lot of the time like the music wasn't keeping up with the vocals and that it was almost out of time in my ears. Well, I'm like, what the hell is going on here? And it's no negative on anyone playing their instruments. They're all doing a great job. And then you kind of get like, so you get those harsher vocals, quiet at first, you build up in a volume to a degree, but they're never dominant. I just didn't really see the point of them because the other singer's dominating all of it. And it's like, well, if you're going to have that, maybe have that take over for those sections because only a little section and so on. It I just thought it was a bit boring.
Oh, sorry, nodded off. In a jokey way, while I was listening to it, I did at one point in my head call them the Coldplay of metal. But that's overly harsh. That's not fair. There are things I didn't like. I don't, you know, I'm less open to the sort of post rock, gazy sort of stuff than Carl is. So if Carl struggled with it a bit, I was probably always going to struggle with it a bit. I musically, I liked it. I like the music. I just don't like, didn't particularly like his vocals. Not because he can't sing or anything, because he can, but I just get bored with the vocals and loathe vocals. And the mix of the kind of soft, gentle, dreamy stuff with the harsh one would be really good if they just turned Loathe up a little bit. You know, it was really, really far back, I felt. So, you know, it was there in the background and I was kind of straining to listen to it. And then with the one kind of lyric kind of word coming up on the screen was throwing me off as well, because it's like he's saying a whole line and then you're just going wild. I'm like, but what about the rest? And then it'd do a whole line and it'd go mine. I'm like, damn it, I don't know what else he's saying. So yeah, at one point I thought that the two guitarists, or it might have been a bassist and guitarist on either side, were potentially had headphones on and were jamming out to a completely different song because they were going fucking mental while the song was in like a much sort of calmer state. You know, and I was like, what are they listening to? I want to listen to that. Put that on. But now, look, you know, it's not a bad song. Musically, I quite like it. I think it's got some cool rhythm. It's got some nice riffs. The drums are good. I don't know what they're like as a band overall. Like, if the singer is always doing that style all the way through an album, I think I'd get sick of it pretty quickly. If that's a song on an album where he mixes it up a bit, it probably, you know, it probably wouldn't be quite so bad.
Yeah.
You know, I can tell you what the guitarist and bass player were listening to. Loathe. Yeah. Go on, Dan, you were the one that I suppose probably needed the convincing most.
I like it.
Yeah.
I don't think it's revolutionary, but I like it. Yeah, that's. I'd probably put it in like a sleep playlist. Just nice, relaxing, chill.
I don't think it's that fucking relaxing. It's still got heavy drums and guitars and stuff. It's the vocals, isn't it? I select the vocals, and that could be a sleep story.
Yeah.
It's strange.
Mixing like, in with some whale singing.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, you read through the comments, and it's like, you know, sometimes you wonder, like, what you're sort of, like, not hearing. You know, the first comment's blanket, dreamy vocals plus hard vocals equals perfect. This song is amazing. And it's like, of course, that's a person's opinion, so on that kind of thing, but it's, between the three of us, I don't think any of us would say that was an amazing song.
No, I like
that. No, I don't think it. Yeah. It's not bad. It's not amazing, but it's not bad.
It's that, isn't it? It's squarely in the middle in that it hasn't really, it's not made no impact, and it's kind of like, but there's nothing to hate about it either.
No, yeah. No, it's absolutely, it's fine.
Unexciting, but there you go. Blanket and Loathe. In awe is fine. Let us know your thoughts in the comments.
Well done.
Thank you very much for watching. You can check us out on gbhbl.com as well as on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and Tumblr. Go to Patreon to help us out over there. That's patreon.com/gbhbl as well as Big Cartel, where you can find some of our merchandise. We have a podcast running on SoundCloud and Apple Podcasts. And of course, if you like this video, do us a favour, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow. Games, horror and heavy metal, what else is life for?